Is MLM bad?
To answer your question, MLM is good because like in the Direct Selling Association of the Philippines, which I represent, our objective is to encourage entrepreneurship, legitimate business opportunities for every Filipino. Now, this is in line with the thrust of the government through the DTI in encouraging entrepreneurship, especially micro, small, and medium enterprises. But the key important thing is to make sure that when you join the company, you join a legitimate one.
Right. I actually want to ask Director about that because he has seen good and bad,
the
good
and the
bad, the good, the bad, and the ugly. What have you seen so far? How do you make sure that you join a legit company? And why are some legitimate companies bad?
Multi-level marketing, of course, it is good, no? But then when it is used as a means to scam, so it becomes bad. Mm-hmm. And we run after those scammers because in multi-level marketing, you should be selling a product. And you should be making money because you are able to sell the product. Mm-hmm. But here, in when the emphasis is already on recruitment, and you are no longer selling the product, but you are already selling an investment contract, we run after you because an investment contract is a form of a security, and which under the securities regulation code has to be registered.
And normally for the that's not
for the protection of the investors.
Right. So what do you have to say to that?
Well, just like what Director Aquino mentioned, the objective of any business is to sell products or services. No? Mm. And it is exactly the same with direct selling or network marketing. The only difference being in a retail environment, you sell products or services in a fixed location. Mm-hmm. But with regards to direct selling or network marketing, it is person-to-person selling. But the objective should be to sell products and services to the end user. And as Director Aquino mentioned, it is unfortunate that because of the popularity and attractiveness of the industry, there are many unscrupulous businessmen who use the industry to come up with pyramid scams in the guise of legitimate direct selling and network marketing.
I find it also interesting, I mean, when you talk about focusing on the product you're selling and also the legitimacy of the company, but one of the key lines that I've been exposed to that industry as well is that, no, we're not selling you a product, we're actually selling you a system or wealth or whatnot.
Well,
how do you address that in terms of the kind of practices you try to encourage in DSAP in terms of making sure that they're representing a proper product and a system as well?
With the DSAP, we have what we call the 8-point test to determine whether a company's compensation plan is legitimate or not. This is consistent with the guidelines of the Department of Trade and Industry as embodied in their Administrative Order Number 8, Series of 2002, which defines the definition of pyramiding and which outlines the type of pyramiding that is considered illegal.
To a lot of people, I've seen the 8-point test, and I've also seen so many companies who, at first blush, you'd think that they are following all of those tests, because now as the investment, the area of investments has evolved, there's a gray line now. Some companies appear to be selling a product. But in fact, the emphasis is really on recruitment. So the product might be there. There's a brand. Yeah. They have displays, and you actually hold it when you buy. Have you ever been?
Yes, yes.
Are you open-minded?
Enough.
Right. Well, people buy them.
Yeah.
And they actually hold these products. Some of them are beauty products. Some are skin, whatever. Stem cell, whatever. They just store it and focus on recruitment. So people are now confused, sir, despite the 8-point test. There are products, but how do you differentiate the ones that are really scams from the legit ones?
Here, there should be a product. Right. And that product, you should be able to use it and not to keep it.
Yes.
So if you are not using that product, but then you simply buy because you would like to earn money through recruitment,
right.
Definitely that becomes already a warning sign that the business you are entering into is not a legit one.
Mm.
The most important thing with regards to legitimate companies is that commissions or bonuses are paid based on the sale of products or services.
Okay. Not
while
on recruitment?
In the case of pyramid scams, people earn primarily from recruitment and through the payment of registration fees by the participants.
And the longer the downline is, right?
Right.
So that's one of the most important distinguishing point between legitimate and pyramid scams.
Mm-hmm.
There are also other red flags.
Yes.
If I may share, like an example would be the selling of multiple slots or positions.
Mm.
I guess you've heard some companies say that, okay, why don't you join
three?
The company.
So it's a three-header.
Yeah, exactly.
Three-header.
Or,
there are some 30 headers. No?
30 headers.
So for a legitimate company, it's like a membership club.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You sign up only once, and we try to make it as easy as possible. So we try to make the fee as low as possible, for as low as a few hundred pesos.
Mm.
So if you're being charged registration fee in the thousands, then you may start to ask the question why the registration fee is high. Secondly, you don't have to sign up your name, you know, 3, 5, 10 times. No?
Mm-hmm.
So in an interview with Chairman Herbosa, conducted by Josiah Go, Chairman Herbosa did mention that selling multiple slots is considered as an investment contract and partake the nature of securities.
Yeah,
and should therefore go through the difficult process of registering that security with the SEC. And we all know, when you want to do that, you have to give the SEC your financial statements and your cash flow and everything, all the financial documents, which will prove that your the existence of your company and its health will depend on the sale of the products and not on
and that's a fiduciary responsibility already.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when we talk about the business perspective, so for example, a first-time or wannabe entrepreneur comes in and says, okay, I'm going to devote my life to this. I'm going to build my network down the line. What really will drive them to be successful in terms of getting into a business? Is it the love for a product? Is it the kind of sector they're in? What really differentiates the successful ones from the non-successful ones?
Okay, when you would like to be part of the industry, there are two major ways. One is to, if you have a product that you want to market, you could use direct selling or network marketing as the channel of distribution.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very powerful channel. No? Imagine if you are able to sign up, let's say, 100,000 people in your organization, and you have representatives in each of the 7,000 islands of the Philippines, then imagine you have like 100,000 outlets all over the Philippines, and your reach is all over the country, as opposed to coming up with a retail outlet and having to set up 100,000 stores.
Mm-hmm.
So it is a very good, powerful and cost-effective way to market products. The second option is to join an existing company. It's like getting a franchise of the company.
Mm-hmm.
It's a matter of choosing the product category you would like to venture into, the brand. You start sharing the products, and you're started with your business.
I suppose it goes without saying that you have to be ultra passionate about the product, and to the point that you're a user and an advocate, right?
Yes, that's right. No, it's so difficult to market a product unless you use the products and you believe in the products.